Today I'm joined by Dr. Christopher Hamilton, a faculty member in the University of Arizona's outstanding Lunar and Planetary Laboratory and Department of Lunar and Planetary Sciences. He's also the principal investigator for RAVEN, short for Rover Aerial Vehicle Exploration Network, an exciting collaborative effort led by the university and involving scientists and engineers from around the world. Dr. Hamilton, thank you for joining us today. I hear you're broadcasting live from Reykjavik.
Yeah, it's pretty dark this time of year, but in downtown Reykjavik at the moment.
So can you tell us about your project? What is RAVEN and what do you hope to accomplish with this very exciting project?
Yeah, well, thank you for the opportunity to discuss it a little bit. I'm really excited. It's an opportunity to be able to consider how we can explore a new planetary landscape using a rover and a drone. And so this is a really fantastic way to be able to combine some of the emerging technologies that have really been revolutionizing the exploration of other planetary surfaces, as well as the Earth.
Lead us through the thought process of how you got to this approach.
My background initially was in earth sciences, and I spent a lot of time doing field work. And over the past few years, the ability to use drones has just completely revolutionized how we do our examination of different environments. We use them as scouts, we collect different types of data. The resolution that you can find is fantastic, and just the efficiency is remarkable. And so a really exciting addition to the Mars 2020 instrument suite was a technology demonstration, the Ingenuity drone. And so for the first time being able to demonstrate the ability to fly, the next step is how do you build a more capable rover with the ability to interact with a drone, and what types of instruments do you need on that drone? Is it best to collect images, topography, hyperspectral data? And one of the things we're testing with RAVEN is also the ability to grab a sample, so a natural rock sample, or even potentially fetch a cached sample. So RAVEN is really the opportunity to be able to build on Ingenuity's proof of concept that we can fly on Mars. And the question is, what do we do with that technology next?
Yeah, so this is a NASA-funded project, and you have a truly impressive world-class team. Who is working with you, and is it important that they come from different institutions?
It's certainly a multinational project with a lot of different people. And so RAVEN is funded through a program called PSTAR. And PSTAR stands for the Planetary Science and Technology through Analog Research Program. And it's an opportunity to be able to really work out the kinks of different types of technology and operational scenarios to be able to build space-ready hardware. And so our project includes a number of different groups. And so in the United States, for instance, we have the University of Arizona, the Jet Propulsion Lab, including a number of people on the Mars 2020 team, also Honeybee Robotics, the University of Tennessee, and Howard University. And so this group is really focused on the drone part of RAVEN, as well as the science operations. But to be able to work with this type of project, we need international partners. And one of them is the Canadian Space Agency. And the CSA is going to be providing a Mars analog rover, very similar to Curiosity, which is already on Mars, and the new Perseverance rover. And we're also working with the MDA Corporation and the University of Western Ontario. And they're the ones that have initially built this rover and have the most experience using it. So together we'll be able to bring this technology to Iceland, but it's also critical to work with the local community here. And so the area that we're working in is in the Icelandic Highlands. It's now a new UNESCO World Heritage Site. It's absolutely spectacular. And we want to be able to work with local expertise at the University of Iceland, as well as the Vatnajökull National Park. And so those organizations are really helping us to be able to bring new types of technologies to Iceland and try something that otherwise would be extremely challenging. And this is basically the paradigm that's always the case for planetary exploration, international teams working together on complex problems.
Dr. Hamilton, thank you so much for giving us a little insight into the world you live in and the complexities. And we're just so happy that you're here at the University of Arizona. Try to stay warm and stay safe there. And we look forward to you coming home very soon.
Thank you very much.